Hello, this is Rick from Rick's Ranch. Some of you may know from MrTruck.com. I am here on my ranch taking some video of some antique machinery that I have. And I wanted to let everybody see what this old combine was. Now, if you don't know what a combine is, what it is a combination of a reaper, which is this part right here, and a combine, or a thresher, which is down in here. The purpose being, it saved a farmer the farmer could do two operations in one operation. So how it would work, your crop would, here I'll give you an example using this stick. There would be sickle sections being driven inside of here. Depending on the side of the section, this would come in here and then it would come over and clip it off. A very simple system. In fact, here's the sickle right here. This would travel between the two points, both here and here, and cut the material as it met it. Now, it should also have had a reel on it somewhere that would kind of move the product into the header. This here is a piece of car. Now, this tongue is rather interesting. This would have been, this could have been a horse-drawn unit at one time. Or it may have had an extra piece fitting in there to hook to a drawbar. Here we go. Yes, this was modified to hook to a tractor. This device controlled the machine somehow. Oh, there. The handle needs a new handle. Oh, that still works. Amazing. What it did exactly, I don't know. This was well before my time. Here we're coming to the power plant. The engine that ran this beast was right here. These deals would have held your grease gun and your oil can. Now this engine may have either been a Model A or T engine, but this one here was built by the Continental Motors Corporation or company. And I'm sure it would still be usable if a guy wanted to do it. It had a wooden wheel to drive the machine. The rest of it would have been right here. Now part of this is missing. This here is a clean grain elevator. And that would have been standing upright and feeding into a grain bin. And I may know where that grain bin is, but it's about a 2-block walk up there. And I don't want to do that right now. This here is the cleaning fan. That would have spun and the air moved air across the sieves, which I'll show you in a little bit here. Here's the interior of the combine. Yeah, I've never used this machine, and this is the first time I've ever really looked at it. Let's see if I can. Find something to point things out with. This here, of course, is the beater that kept stuff down against the rest of the rest of the machine. Here's a rattle chain, brought stuff in from the header or from the cylinder. I haven't found the cylinder yet. That clear down there is the grain pan. That's what transferred the grain itself, and it looks to be in pretty good shape. And then the fan would throw the stuff up onto these finger deals, and these finger deals, it's called straw walkers, would move the straw out the back of the machine. And they end right here at this point. So the straw would come falling out the back, and then the grain would travel along here down underneath these fingers. There's a pan going that way to the clean grain elevator. And then as it come back here, this here has an auger in the bottom yet. And this, the chaff and the unthreshed grain would fall down in there and be taken back to the front of the machine to do the process all over again, which is this auger right here. This would carry it back to the front of the machine. Okay, it ends here. Then it has a chute that comes back down inside the combine. Now here's an interesting wrench. If you got into some weeds or some wet material, your combine could plug up. Therefore, you had to come back here, loosen these bolts, let the cylinder drop down. Now, I'm not sure if I can get a picture of that cylinder or not. I think maybe I can. Then you would put this wrench on there and work it free. Look at that, it still turns. I don't think this has been used in at least 40 years. Now here's an oil pan off of something. Looks like its purpose was to hold the lid down. And here is the, yes, we're getting there. Well, maybe not. Okay, the Thresher. Oh. Yeah, you can see it down in there. Just here it is. This is the cylinder. These are rasp bars. They spin very rapidly and rub the grain together. When the grain's dry, it splatters all over and shells out quite nicely, normally. Now let's cover that back up. Now the reaper part, yeah, this here would have had some kind of markings on it, I believe. This moves the cylinder up and down. Now here's a port. Here you can see what the cylinder rubs against. Those are the concaves. And there's holes in there that allow the grain to fall through as the cylinder strikes it and shatters it. Oh boy, this is quite a deal. What is this thing? Not familiar with all of these components on this machine. Here, this is an access port to clean the straw. Like I said, if you plug your machine, which is a common thing, that opens up, you can clean it out. Now the reaper part, this is the thresher part. Back here, this is the combine part from here back. And this is the reaper part. This probably turns a lower rattle chain. I'll come back around here. Yes, here's what's left of the back reel right here. Here's rattle chain. There we go. What's left of it. And that would have cut. Cut the full width of this little platform. Oh, this is the outside edge of this platform here. The sickle would have ran the full width of this here. And then this chain, okay, here's the chain here. This chain would have gathered it up and took it over to the thresher. This was a major advancement, I'll guarantee you. Although it may not look like much at the moment. And then the bat reel, what's left of it, acted as a rake, moving the material in to the header. And then this little auger here would assist it in pushing the material over to the center. So it all went up through that mouth there. Oh yes, I'm still working on this myself. Yeah. This deal is broken. McCormick didn't have it. Some companies had a, maybe they did. Had a separate plate inside this hole that you could change with rivets. Well, there's a rivet. You could change those out and keep your sickle sharp without having to buy this whole thing here. They don't do that anymore. This whole thing makes more money than these little pieces here. So anyway, this is a McCormick. Is this a Deering? McCormick Deering? It's a number 60. Let's go to the other side. This needs a little bit of attention here. But I'm sure this could be made to run again. Yes, here we go. It's a McCormick Deering. And exactly how they come up with that name, I don't know. But it's the number 60. And of course, here's some good advice. Keep hands away from gear, sprockets, chains, and all moving parts while machine is in motion. That was good advice. So here's the top end of the clean grain elevator. And if anybody has any interest, I'll try and get videos of that equipment too. Now, sprocket turn this. You pulled the grain up these paddles and dumped it in the grain bin. It's very simple. Some of the newer combines had a clean grain tank that had an auger that dumped into a wagon or a small truck. This one here may have dumped into bags. I don't know. I don't remember. I didn't use it. Well, there we got it. Oh, this little motor's cool. Here's your gas tank. Got a little dirt in it. It looks like it'd work. Here's your clutch. Now this fan, this lever is the clutch that engaged the machine. That'd be very interesting to see inside of that thing. But for now, that's all I can show you. Hope you enjoyed it. Rick out.